Hey guys, it's me, Richie, and today's video I'm going to be reviewing Spider-Man No Way Home. Now, before I start, I just wanted to let you guys know that this video will contain spoilers, so if you haven't seen Spider-Man No Way Home, please stop watching this video, go to the theater, and watch that movie, because that movie is awesome. Alright, so leave. Stop watching. Now, for those that stood, holy shit, that movie was fucking awesome. There was a few things I wish that weren't leaked, because I feel like there's certain moments of this film that I would probably have teared up more, especially like the big cameos, the Daredevil one, Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire. Like, I think if I didn't know about those leaks, because it was everywhere, like Twitter, like everywhere in the news, so it was kind of like hard not to like see it. And as someone who works in the industry that kind of like involves like being online a lot, so it was no way around it, you know. So especially Twitter, I love Twitter, so fuck Twitter spoiled everything for me. I mean, the cameos, like I said, everyone knew about those cameos, but if it wasn't for those like leaks, I think this movie would have been like a 10 out of 10 for me, because as of right now it's a 9 out of 10. And probably my favorite Spider-Man movie. I mean, before that movie, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse was like my number one Spider-Man movie. And then a second would be Spider-Man 2 with Tobey Maguire. Because Tom Holland's like Spider-Man movies, they never felt like Spider-Man. It just felt like something was off. But this movie, No Way Home, it felt like an actual Spider-Man movie. Like the thing that he was missing, like he is Spider-Man. And yeah, I guess him going through like so many losses throughout the years. Well, one, the big one, Tony Stark, then losing his aunt. In this movie, I guess this whole MCU first two movies of him, whatever, was basically like an origin story to like the death of Aunt May, which is basically a replacement of like Ben, you know, Uncle Ben. So I guess they just changed Uncle Ben with Aunt May for his origin story. But the movie was awesome. I freaking loved it. I actually saw it twice. And yeah, it was a great movie. Great movie. It's really long, but it was an awesome movie. And the cool thing too is like, you know, going into the movie, I kind of assumed, you know, because we all saw leaks and stuff about Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield. But when you actually see them on the screen, their chemistry is just phenomenal. Like, it's just that everything just runs so smooth. Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield, Tom Holland, like, it was perfect chemistry. Like, it didn't feel like forced, you know, like compared to like Spider-Man 3 with Tobey Maguire, when they just threw all these villains just to, you know, make it look nice and crazy, like the Avengers, or I don't even think, was Avengers out back then? I don't know. I think they were just trying to do that because they wanted to do Sinister Six. Was it Sinister? No, that was Andrew Garfield. It's Andrew Garfield. Either way, it didn't feel forced. Like, they just wanted to add more villains just to sell toys or whatever. But this one felt very organic, and everyone had their moment of shine. Everyone had their moment to shine and stuff. But it was awesome. It was insane. And even though I saw the movie twice, I swear the ending scene with Tom Holland, you know, making his own suit. The suit he was wearing, was that the 90s, you know, like the Spider-Man 90s show? Because I swear it looked like, I thought I saw the big red spider on his back. But I swear it looked like it, you know? I saw it twice and I just couldn't get like a very, very good, like, clear shot at it. But I swear it was it. But so let me know in the comments below if that was like the costume from the 90s from Spider-Man the Animated. Because if so, that just made the movie awesome. Because I loved that show. You know, I grew up watching Spider-Man, X-Men, like that, the 90s shows and stuff. So it was awesome. I loved it. And I can't wait for the movie to come out in Blu-ray or 4K Blu-ray or digital video on demand and stuff, because I'm going to buy it. It was awesome. Now, yeah, I just wanted to share my thoughts about this movie. Let me know in the comments below, like, what were your reactions on certain parts of the movies? Because I don't... the first time I saw it, man, when Daredevil showed up, the whole audience was like screaming, like, ah. So I was excited because I am a huge fan of Daredevil. So for them to actually show him like appear, I'm like, oh man, they're bringing him back. Hopefully they bring him back like for a TV series. I don't want to see a movie just because I really enjoy the TV series they had on Netflix. So for him to come back and have another series, I'm kind of worried when it goes to Disney Plus and stuff, because I don't know how the ratings would be, because you know it's PG-13. Daredevil's more like rated R. So let me know your comments below. What were your thoughts about the movie, you know, Spider-Man No Way Home? And I'll see you guys in the next video. Again, sorry I haven't done a video in a long time. Just been really busy. Life happens. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So, see ya.